The trick to this dynamic optimization is recognizing what the state of the protocol is at any point of time and how the protocol has to react to an input event. Whether the event is coming from the top or from the bottom, how the protocol has to react to that event is the trick. And this is what is called the common case predicate, CCP for short. For example, if we receive a packet and the state of the protocol says that if a particular sequence number is received, then we are ready to deliver the packet to the application. If that is the state of the protocol, that is what is called a common case predicate. These common case predicates are predicates that can be derived from the state of the protocol by looking at the conditional statement. So from the conditional statements in the microprotocol that has been implemented, available to you, we can actually synthesize these common case predicates. And once these common case predicates have been synthesized, then we can say, well, if that common case predicate is satisfied, then you don't have to go through all the cruft indicated by the multiple layers of the microprotocols assembled on top of one another. But instead, we can do a much simpler processing, and that's what is called the bypass code. So in the dynamic optimization, once these common case predicates have been identified by looking at the conditional statements in the microprotocol, dynamic optimization framework generates this bypass code and inserts it into this framework. So I'm going to complicate this picture a little bit now. So what we have is a common case predicate. For instance, it says, is the sequence number in the packet what I'm expecting it to be? Is this the particular sequence number? And if that is the sequence number that I'm looking for, then I can execute this bypass code and completely eliminate all these multiple layers of protocol and go directly to the upper layer, perhaps all the way up to the application. On the other hand, if it is not the common case predicate that is being satisfied, then you have to do the normal processing of giving the packet to this microprotocol, and it does its own thing. And you can see that this kind of framework can be applied to every layer. So you can take this as a single layer and find out what the common case predicate for this microprotocol and use that common case predicate to signify whether we want to use the bypass code or whether we want to go through the microprotocol. And we can collapse multiple layers like this and derive a common case predicate that collapses all of these layers into a single predicate. And if it is satisfied, then you can eliminate processing the packet through all of these layers and simply go through the bypass code to get to the upper layers. That's the beauty of this dynamic optimization. And it's completely automated, and it comes from the power of the theorem proving framework of NuPrl. And the optimization theorems that is in the NuPrl framework proves the equivalence of the bypass code to the layers of protocol that it is replacing. That's the beauty of the NuPrl framework, that in the theoretical world of the theorem proving framework, we can actually prove through optimization theorems that the bypass code does exactly the same job as all of these multiple layers of microprotocols that would have processed this message. So once we have done this dynamic optimization and collapsing the layers, generating the bypass code, starting, of course, with the common case predicate derived from the microprotocols, then we are ready to convert the optimized NuPrl code back to OCaml. And again, I mentioned that there is a tool that's available, straightforward tool that converts the NuPrl code to the OCaml code. And the final OCaml code that we generate through this conversion process is the optimized version of the original OCaml code. And the theorem proving framework can assert that the original unoptimized OCaml code is equivalent to the new optimized OCaml code because of the power of the theorem proving framework. This is where we've sort of put together theory and practice to get the best of both worlds. A word of caution, however, there's a difference between optimization and verification. All that the NuPrl framework is doing is optimization, not verifying whether the OCaml code is adhering to the behavioral spec of IO automata. That's not what this is being done. What we are doing here is saying that we take an unoptimized OCaml code and produce an optimized OCaml code, and through the theoretical framework, we can assert that the two are functionally equivalent. So this exercise has shown the path to synthesizing complex system software, starting from specification to implementation to optimization, putting theory and practice together.